because the pieces of crust are compressed together very tightly. The powerful forces that compress this crust also cause it to move very slowly. When two pieces that are next to each other get pushed in different directions, they will stick together for a long time, but eventually the forces pushing them will force them to break apart and move. This sudden shift in the rock shapes all of the rock around it. Earthquakes occur because of the sudden release of stored energy. This energy has built up over long periods of time as a result of tectonic forces within the earth. Most earthquakes take place along faults in the upper 25 miles of the earth's surface when one side rapidly moves relative to the other side of the fault. This sudden motion causes shock waves to originate from their point of origin called the commons and travel through the earth. It is these seismic waves that can produce ground motion which people call an earthquake. Each year there are thousands of earthquakes that can be felt by people, and over 1 million that are strong enough to be recorded by instruments. Strong seismic waves can cause great local damage and they can travel large distances. But even weaker seismic waves can travel far and can be detected by sensitive scientific instruments called seismographers.
Sikat na ka.
Thank you, speaker. Now we can proceed to the question and answers. So the first group to ask questions is the negative side. Then the other side is given 1 minute to answer. So the question for the first group.
What is important to you, the arctic trees?
How important is the earthquake dream?
It is important because it makes us ready and alert to prevent accidents and unexpected situations or happenings. And when you practice what to do in an emergency, you don't have to worry about what to do when the emergency happens. And people are less likely to panic, do the wrong thing, and get hurt.
Okay, so it's your turn to ask question and then answer by the next the group.
Why you disagree about earthquake dream?
Why do you disagree? Why do you disagree? About having earthquake dream?
Because earthquake dream will make you slow.
My earthquake dream will
make you slow when the earthquake is going to kill me faster.
May make you slow? Are you satisfied with the answer? Huh? Oh, do you have additional answers?
Because when the earthquake comes, the people will panic and cannot perform the drill.
They cannot perform the drill when there is an actual reality. Okay, next question.
How can communities be more protected against earthquake
dreams? How can communities be protected against earthquake dreams? Use your own idea. Kasi yung your speech is already been spoken. Okay, balik yan. Use your own idea. Why? Can you repeat the question?
How can communities be more protected against earthquake dreams?
How can communities be protected, more protected? Using earthquake dreams.
They will be alert, and when the earthquake comes,
cover and hold. And when the earthquake is moving slowly, you can slowly get inside, get outside the house or any rooms. You can go and go in the open space so that there is no harm.
On your side.
What if there are real earthquake? What will you do?
What will you do if there is a real earthquake and you don't do any earthquake thing? What will you do? Provided that you don't practice earthquake thing.
The building is useless when earthquake comes, because the people will all get panic. The drill cannot protect you in the reality. The drill cannot protect you in the reality.
Okay, last question.
What if the earthquake suddenly comes to your community and the people get panicked? Can they still perform the earthquake drill?
Oh, can the people still perform the earthquake drill? Or the things to do during the earthquake? There's already an earthquake.
People have already know what they're going to do when there is an earthquake.
So when people that are used to doing earthquake drills, they already know what to do when earthquake comes.
Because of the earthquake drill,
the practice continues. Yeah, additional questions. Okay. Okay, from the positive side.
You say that all people know how to prevent earthquakes without doing earthquake drill. In Pohoran Cebu, there is a 7.2 magnitude earthquake, and many people died because of panicness of the people. And why did you say so that earthquake drill is useless when people of Cebu and Bohol is when people of Cebu and Bohol know what to do?
How can you say that it is useless? Bring up the earthquake people in our communities who are used to stopping earthquake drills and having them survive. What is your reaction? Okay. Yeah, you can share my idea. She was asking why is it that communities who are used to having earthquake drills know what to do during an actual earthquake and many are safe. And why do you still say that it's useless or it's not necessary? Given the fact that there are many people who are safe and know what to do. Additional questions. Or rephrase the question.
You say that when the earthquake comes, the people would be panicked. Why does the Philippine government support this activity? Is this that for you?
Now, what do you think? Now, what do you think the government is supporting this program of having earthquake drills every year? Why is this still saying that it is not necessary? Given the fact that the Philippine government is endorsing this or obligating a lot of establishments, almost all of the establishments, to have earthquake drills. Daligan din sana, we'll have the last question before we summarize. Okay, let's give a little time for the negative side to formulate your answers.
Kenapa si Mirin pada pakit
kecil? Why do you still believe that earthquake drills are not important?
Si aku Mirin, tapi masih Mirin no. Pakit kecil si Mirin, tapi kedat-kedat. Wow, betul.
The establishment to conduct earthquake drills. Hey, Lulus.
Because government have made their own communities so they perform the earthquake
drill. Because the government wanted to protect
their own communities.
Okay, question. Last question from the negative side.
Dina.
Okay, question.
Why should we practice earthquake drill if we don't know when earthquake comes?
Okay, why do we practice earthquake drills even if we do not know when it comes? When it comes. Why do we still practice it even though we do not know when will it strike? When will it occur?
We just watch the television or radio, there's an earthquake and we must always be alert and prepared if there's an earthquake coming. And that is why the earthquake drill is support because Philippines supports earthquake drill so that all the people in the Philippines should be alert and prepare the earthquake comes, and so that the Philippines won't have any problems in the deaths of the people, because the people are safe and know what to do.
Okay, thank you everyone for your time. Now, if you are the one to decide, which side are you on? Is it having earthquake drill or no need for having earthquake drill? All of you.
Having earthquake drill.
So, you are given a chance to choose. You would rather choose having earthquake drill, right? Because we have a saying that practice makes
perfect.
So, if we always practice earthquake drill, we know what to do, right? Because it becomes our second nature. So, whenever earthquake strikes, we already know what to do because we do it every time, right? Every now and then. We all know that it saves lives, right? It saves lives and properties. That's the reason why our government is actually encouraging us and obligating the different establishments to conduct this every year. That is very important. And we should always be ready, right? We should always be ready. We should always know what to do. So thank you and good afternoon.